bring transformational sciences as part of your living, as part of your thinking, as part of your existing. नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। इस समय हमारे साथ उपस्थित सभी दर्शकों और भक्तों का मैं प्रेम एवं आशीर्वाद सहित स्वागत करता हूँ। आई वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज, डिसाइपल्स, समाजी, सत्संगी, श्रीमहंस, महंस, कोटारी, स्थानीदार्स सिटिंग विद अस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड थ्रू नित्यानंद टीवी, लोटस टीवी, साधना टीवी, ईश्वर टीवी, जनश्री टीवी, टू वे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग, हैविंग नयन दीक्षा इन मेनी सिटीज, in many countries around the world. Cities sitting with us in two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Deeksha. Nityananda Nagaram, Hyderabad. Adi Nityananda Dhyana Peetam, Avattipalayam. Houston, Kalahasti, Kuala Lumpur, Palani, Guadalupe, Rameshwaram, San Jose, Madurai. Seattle, Chidambaram, Los Angeles, Arunachalam, Toronto, Kailasam, Oklahoma, Somanatham. Charlotte, Srisailam, Ohio, Prayag, Devon, UK, Bangalore City Center, Camas, Hong Kong, London, Kashi, Dubai, Vaidyanatham, Gupta Kashi, Acapulco, Mexico, Pobrad, Slovakia, Scottsdale, Arizona, Oman, Sivagangai, Ohio, Prayag and Singapore, Singapuram. I welcome all of you with my love and blessings. Today, Mahadeva is gracing us wearing the Rudraksha and the banyan tree leaves. The Rudraksha came from his blissful tears. Banyan tree came from his own body. So, he is wearing his own skin. Banyan tree is equivalent to the skin of Mahadeva. The leaves of the banyan tree and the Rudraksha is gracing us today, wearing both in the Leela of Tirunila Gandharana Leela. It means that when he drank the Alahala poison, Devi held his throat and made the poison stay in the throat itself. So the throat has become blue. That is why today if you see closely, Mahadeva's throat is painted in blue. That's the Leela in which he is gracing us today.
महाराजाय नमः कर्पूर गौरम करुणावतारम संसार सारम हृदयेन्द्रहारम सदा वसंतम हृदयारविंदे भवं भवानी सहितम।
लेट्स एंटर इनटू टुडेज सत्संग। I want to emphasize on a fact today. The modern day Hindus lost the importance of cognitive shift in their day-to-day life. This is one of the main reason why so much of heart disease, please understand, in the world, Indians are the leading ethnic society, a leading group dying in heart attacks and heart related problems. The study in the United States says 600 times more than, 600%, not 600 times, 600% more than an American, an Indian gets heart problems and dies due to heart problems. See, our whole constitution is built to think and function from cognitive shift with a transformed consciousness. Our system is not built for running out of fear or favor. It is designed to run out of inspiration and energy. Please understand. But last 100 years, almost our transformation science is distanced from our day-to-day life. Please understand. Don't come and tell me, justify. No. See, last 20, 30 years, so much of crowd in the temple. Crowd in the temple does not mean the transformational sciences are back to the lifestyle. People go to temple for various reasons. If you are a youth in the village, you know why you go to temple. If you are an old man in the village, you know why you are going to temple. If you are a child in the village, you know why you are going to temple. Child in the village goes to temple for prasad. Youth in the village goes to temple to see the girls. The old man in the temple goes to the old man in the village goes to temple just for relaxing. The crowd in the temple does not show that, does not mean the transformational sciences have become our lifestyle. The crowd in the temple has multiple reasons. The other day I met a Swami, he was telling me, I heard for Shivaratri only 10,000 people come to your ashram, to my temple, 25,000 people come. I just smiled and kept quiet because the context from which people are coming. I asked him, what do they do? He said, I don't know. They come and pour some water and go. I don't go and see them. I said, what do you do Shivaratri night? No, oh, by 10:30 I go to room and sleep. I said, thank you. Understand, now you will understand. Crowd in the temple does not mean the transformation sciences are revived. I am happy about the crowd in the temple. Whatever purpose, whatever reason you go to temple, at least you are going to temple. Great. Along with eating the prasad, at least 2 minutes you will remember Mahadeva. While you are seeing the girls in the, at least like a commercial break, you will see Mahadevi. While you are relaxing, at least 2 minutes you will remember about Mahadeva. I appreciate going to temple. I am not saying it is not good or anything, but all I am trying to tell you is that cannot be the scale to say the transformation sciences have become part of our life. Please understand, I have taken over our country . The education system has become such I have no word to describe that. The context from which the education system is developed itself is such a low vision, low view. Anything from the Indian tradition is not respected. Anything. From our source is no more a reality. It is surprising how this great country this great Bharat Desha is so fastly moving out of our founding father's vision. The transformational sciences becoming part of our day-to-day thinking is very important. If the sciences start becoming part of our life, we will have such a beautiful, such an amazing social and economical strength. Please understand, the transformational sciences of Hinduism is not anti-life. Even a Swami or Mataji who are not even married, even their life is dedicated for the welfare of the society, constantly enriching and contributing to society. Please understand, the transformational science of Hinduism is not against the life. It makes you more and more rich, more and more expansive, more and more strong, more and more intelligent, more and more powerful. Joint families breaking, children are not doing the father's profession. Lot of funny things in India. These so-called revolutionaries, they go around and tell everyone, abuse Varnashrama Dharma, saying, why should a son do the same profession of the father? After doing all these abuses, they get into power, but their son becomes their father, a successor. Finally, who suffers in this country, you know? The poor fellows who listen to all the revolutionaries and throw away that age-old dharmic lifestyle, they are only in depression and suffering. As usual with their empty begging bowl. In our tradition, that when we say, do the same profession as father, we are creating an opportunity for specialization. Opportunity for specialization in every field. Our civilization had specialization. Can you imagine 1,000 years before we built a granite building which was the world record till 250 years before? Even now, the largest granite structure in the world. Tanjore Temple. Tallest and largest granite structure in the world. Cambodia is not made out of granite. That's a different stone. Light stones, easy to transport. Granite is difficult to carve and difficult to move. This kind of monument can't be done by one generation, or the intelligence developed by one generation. So for the specialization purpose, that concept is created. I had a disciple in South America, Brazil. Once he came to the ashram, and when I went to South America also, I stayed with him. There was some chat, and he was telling that South America is, there is a lot of corruption. And usually I don't speak about India in any low light or in a very disrespectful way. I never speak. I just kept quiet. He's an Indian only. That guy with whom I was chatting, he was Indian, Indian devotee, Indian settled there. Slowly he asked me, how is corruption in India, Swamiji? I said, I do not know, I am not in that field, so I do not know. I was trying to avoid. Then he said, no, no, Swamiji, you are not telling me. One big politician's son came and stayed here, and I only hosted him. He wanted to stay in my house. I asked him, what is there? No, he came to learn how to keep the money in different countries. I started laughing and I said, don't bring all these to me. I don't even want to listen. I told him, don't even tell me the name. I just don't want to hear all this. He was laughing and he said, what happened to all our dharma, spirituality, everything, Swamiji? I said, please understand, because we have not brought the transformation science into our lifestyle, neither citizens trust the leaders, nor leaders trust the citizens. When the leaders and citizens don't trust each other, the third party, the other countries come and exploit their insecurity. That is the way the whole civilization is going down. The leaders are trying to keep the money outside this country for their security, and citizens are trying to dethrone everyone. There is a deep distrust. Citizens believe any corruption charge without thinking second time. Because of that, charging somebody with some crime, charging, accusing somebody as corrupt is very easy. It doesn't take anything. But the moment he is charged, his future is doomed, and people start believing. Such deep distrust with the people. So naturally the leaders think the money kept outside the country is the only security, safety they have for their future. They themselves do not trust their own country as their secured future. This deep distrust is destroying the whole civilization. I can go on and on and on, expand the volume of the problem. The volume of the problem we manifested because we did not make the science of enlightenment as a part of our life. Yesterday night I was watching a program in Times Now channel. Somebody called Mentalist has come, and he does something like a whatever number you think he will tell that number, and whatever number he thinks he will make you write that number. And that is such a big show. He is from some country outside India, and they are promoting him, and everyone is going gaga over him. No, I appreciate his capabilities, no disrespect to him. I was just smiling. Any of my Gurukul kid will do this. What an unfortunate thing. We have become so poor in developing the mental powers that we need to bring some foreigner to do this small show on demonstrating mental powers. What an unfortunate condition, situation. Even if they are importing food, I can tolerate. But they are importing the mentalists to India. Are we that poor? When I grew up in my village, the sadhus who walk in the street will demonstrate all these great powers. This materialization, teleportation, whatever you guys see and go gaga over it. Ah, Swamiji blessed immediately. Vibhuti materialized in Kuala Lumpur, Palani. Few days before, in Kulim Tiruthani, after Kalpataru, so much Vibhuti got materialized. They sent a photograph and all that. The moment I saw that photograph, I was remembering. In my village, the sadhus who walk in the street, who come for food, they will demonstrate all these powers. It is not magic, it is a spiritual power. Or I can say, I don't even want to use the word spiritual power, mental power. Siddhis. They will demonstrate all these siddhis just for one square meal. And they will be so happy if you just give them one meal. Four roti and little sabji, that's all. Or four idli and little chutney, that's all. They will demonstrate. It's not that they cheat or they are street magicians. No, it's a siddhi. The spiritual, the mental power. And even who was demonstrating yesterday, it was genuine power. I have no question. I don't doubt his powers. All I am trying to tell is that we have become that poor that we have to import mentalists to show these powers to Indians. What a sad condition. Because we did not Live the transformational science as a lifestyle. We don't even want to spend for transformational science. Indians spend lakhs and lakhs for heart surgery and kidney transplant and so many surgeries. They don't want to spend few thousands for learning about enlightenment. Not only they don't want to spend, their government also doesn't want to spend. Because they don't want to spend, government doesn't want to spend. It's unfortunate. Literally unfortunate. That we are not ready to spend for this transformational science as part of our life. Even if I share this knowledge freely, we are not spending the time to make that as part of us. Please understand, essence of today's satsang, strive, work to make this transformational science as part of your life and part of everyone's life. Make inner awakening happen to you and happen to everyone around you. We spend so much on jewelry, clothes, surgeries. Unfortunately, we don't give that much of importance to the transformation science. It is not that we don't have money. So much we spend in drinking. You know, 30,000 crore Tamil Nadu earns by alcohol. I was shocked. 30,000 crore of money we spend on alcohol. You see the amount of money we spend on the comforts. Luxuries, comforts, luxury, but we forget the way we think is our basic need. Learning to think, Kalpataru is teaching you to learn to think in a right way. Teaching you to learn to think in a right way. Listen, don't give me the reason inner awakening is costly, that is why I am not able to come, or I am not able to tell others to come. If you look into their life, the amount of money they spend on alcohol and medical care, one fragment if they spend on inner awakening, both will not be required. Alcohol and so much medical care. Somehow human beings are addicted to go and get the disease and pay for curing the disease. Then preventing it completely. And nobody wants to teach you. Everyone wants you to have the disease, only then they will have money. Medical industry is the largest successful economically, a best investment industry. It has become an industry, understand. It's no more a service. Listen, bring transformational sciences as part of your living, as part of your thinking, as part of your existing.
I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, and enriching with eternal bliss. Nityananda, thank you.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.